Okay, we're looking at velocity, which is an application of our rate of change, and we're going to work out some average velocities for this graph here. Now, when we're working out these averages, we're actually working out the constant rate of change for these because they're all straight lines. If it was a curve, then it would be a true average. So we have got some information from our graph. We want to look at the interval 0 to 2. So we know between 0 and 2, it has gone up 15. And that's kilometers. So we've got, we can set it up as the, with the rule doing our 15 take 0 over 2 take 0. So we get 15 over 2, so 7.5. And we can write that as kilometers per hour because we've got hours and we've got kilometers there. Between 2 and 4, it's going across 2 again, but it's only going up 5. So we've got 5 over 2. Which is 2.5 kilometers per hour. So obviously going a bit slower, and we can see that because this is steeper in this section than this section here. Now in this section, it's returning back to its starting point, but what we'll use, we'll talk about that because velocity is directional. So we're looking at the positive being moving away from the start and the negative returning to the start. So in this one, we will get a negative gradient. So we've got our between 4 and 6, so we know that it has gone down 20 kilometres in 2 hours. So we have negative 10 kilometres per hour. And we can see that is our steepest line of the three there, so we can see our velocities. Now in the next one, next video, I'm going to look at the tangent, and this is a real lead-in to our derivatives from first principles. And I'll be using the notation for that.